Welcome to our virtual classroom. Join me for some fun learning. Hello, it's Ms. Nicole of Legacy Lineage Online Learning. Thank you for joining me as we take a second during Black History Month to talk about dental health. Okay, so February is a time where they talk about dental health. And when I was a kid, and I would always think about the tooth fairy, I never saw any tooth fairies that looked like me. But I found a wonderful story to share for Black History Month with a black little girl and the tooth fairy. And it says, How to Trick the Tooth Fairy. Also joining me, I have our friend over here who's ready for a doctor visit. And I have some different tools and I'm gonna check his teeth later. And then we have some other dental things we'll talk about. And we're gonna do an experiment and look at some fun coloring resources for dental month. All right, so let's start with our story. I am reading, look at me. Time to put the toys away and listen to what I say. 1, 2, 3, eyes on me. This is the front of the book. This is the back of the book. And this is the spine. This is the front of the book. It tells us the name of the story, How to Trick the Tooth Fairy. And this is the back of the book. It lets us know it's the end. And this is the spine. It holds the pages of the book together, just like the spine in your back holds your body together. All right, so let's talk about dental health. Did you know that you only have 2 sets of teeth? You have your baby teeth, and then when your baby teeth come out, you have your adult teeth. And in order to keep your teeth healthy, you have to brush twice a day and you need to floss. If you don't do those things, you could end up with dog breath. Look at this. His breath is all green when he opens his mouth because his breath smells bad. And look at our friend underneath dog breath. He didn't brush his teeth and you see all the yuck that he has all over his teeth. Another thing that we need to remember is that we need to eat the right foods and healthy foods so that we have a healthy, beautiful smile. Okay, so let's see. We need to eat different foods in the different food groups before we get into our story. So her teeth, our character's teeth, didn't come out because she doesn't eat the right foods. They came out because it's time for her big teeth to come in. And look at all the healthy foods on these children's plate, which are gonna help their gums and their teeth to be healthy and strong. And look over here, they're cheering because they ate all of their healthy foods. So if you do that, then when it's time for your teeth to come out, it's fine and your adult teeth will grow in. So let's find out what happens when this little girl's teeth come out and the tooth fairy comes. It sounds like she's gonna try to trick her. Uh-oh. And look inside. She has a little treasure box for her teeth. And I like this. I'm using this pointer because this picture is all full of glitter and maybe tooth fairy dust. And so my pointer this time is all full of glitter and tooth fairy dust. Let's find out what happens. Kaylee loved to pull pranks. Twinkle instead of mischief. Prank princess in training. Favorite holiday is April Fool's Day. Cute as a button, sharp as a tack. Comfy shoes for creeping. And this says a twinkle of mischief in her eyes. So they just were describing Kaylee to you. Let's see what else happens. She pulled pranks every day and even on holidays. So let's see what's she doing here. looked like she jumped up on the side of the bed and scared him. And then, oh my goodness, her friends are walking home from school and she is in a tree with water balloons. What do you think she's gonna do when they come walking up the street? I think you're right. And let's see who she's gonna trick. Who's gonna come down the chimney and land on these? Huh, she's trying to trick Santa. She's gonna go on the naughty list. And she's gonna put marbles down. He will go slipping everywhere. She was always looking for her next unsuspecting victim. But was Kaylee the princess of pranks? So let's see what her prank is here. I see her offering her friends some cookies and they're looking, giving her the side eye like, I don't know if we should trust her. But guess what? Behind her back, her cookies are filled with what? Toothpaste. It's gonna taste all chocolatey and minty and toothpastey. No, that would be the first, that would be this little trickster. So Kaylee is not the princess of pranks. It says no, that would be this little trickster, the tooth fairy. Ruling prank princess, smirky smile, fairy wings for quick getaways, more tricks in her bag than teeth, and a magical tooth grabber. But she had no clue whom she was about to meet. And she's asleep. And along comes the tooth fairy. You think she's gonna get her tooth and get out of there? Let's find out. The tooth fairy was expecting to find something small, smooth, and white, not green with webbed feet. Now, if you prank the tooth fairy with a fake frog, you'll get, and she says, eek! Look, her little tooth fairy dust went flying everywhere because she wasn't expecting a frog. And look at Kaylee, giving her the side eye and laughing. And who has the teeth? I guess Kaylee wants to hold on to her teeth, huh? Let's see what happens. For pranking the tooth fairy, you'll get real frogs. Oh my goodness, the tooth fairy made real frogs come in Kaylee's room. Had Kaylee finally met her match? Her mischief-making match? And then look at Kaylee. She says, game on. Looks like she is ready. Game on. Let's see what happens next. So whose turn is it now to pull a prank? It's Kaylee's turn. Let's see what she does. She offered the tooth fairy a slice of pie. I'm so sorry. And if you know anything about fairies, you know they love sweets. The tooth fairy dug in her dessert and suddenly her mouth was on fire. Now, if you prank the tooth fairy with a prankster pie, she'll top it with, let's find out, but first let's look at this pie. So Kaylee offered her pie with what? Hot sauce. It's like, now let's see what the tooth fairy's gonna do. Gobs of ice cream. Look, and she is throwing that ice cream all at Kaylee. So much, she can't even get a chance to eat it. Just gobs and gobs and gobs of ice cream. And this book, already, too much pie and too much ice cream are not healthy treats. If you eat them, you should brush your teeth. They taste good, but too much of them is not good for us and not good for our teeth. So when you eat them, you should take some time and brush your teeth. Kaylee was a mess. Pass the sprayer, please. But once the sprayer was in her hands, Kaylee turned on the tooth fairy. No! Now, if you prank the tooth fairy with a splash of water, she'll make it. Uh-oh. Let's see. Rain, cats and dogs. Yikes! And raining cats and dogs is something called the idiom. And that means that it's not really raining cats and dogs. It's just raining a lot. But guess what? The tooth fairy turned the idiom into something true. Because look at Kaylee. She is surrounded by real raining cats and dogs. How do you think Kaylee's going to answer? They are playing pranks and tricks on one another. Storms scared Kaylee. She ran and she hid behind a closet. The tooth fairy wanted to outprank Kaylee, but frightening her wasn't fun at all. Come out wherever you are. So the tooth fairy feels a little bad because she didn't know that Kaylee was afraid of storms. Kaylee goes and hides, and the tooth fairy just wants to go and find her and help. So she goes up to the door and she says, come out wherever you are. Do you think that Kaylee is really afraid of storms, or is she planning something over here for the tooth fairy? Let's find out. Kaylee sprang out of hiding, surprising the tooth fairy with a burst of bubble gum. Gotcha! See, she was just pranking her. And if you know anything about tooth, it says, oops, and her wand fell. And it says, and if you know anything about tooth fairies, you know a broken wand means. So she shot the bubblegum at her out of the slingshot. It hit her. Her wand falls. She says, oops, my wand. It falls and breaks. But look, the tooth fairy is stuck to the refrigerator and a glob of gum. Again, gum is a sweet treat. And if we eat sweet treats, what do we need to do? Brush our teeth. But we need to remember, only eat whole foods once in a while. That's what we're going to call foods that are not that great for us. They taste great, but they are not great for us. Those are whole foods. That means you want to slow down how much you have those. But the foods that I showed you in the beginning, all of the healthy foods, those are go foods. So let's just take a second from our story and we'll see what happens to the wand afterwards. But you get to have go foods. And like in the back, where when they finished all of their eating at the dinner table, they were eating. I'm going to find the page because it was a really good page with all of the go foods on their plate. Here we go. All of those are go foods. Those foods are good for your body. They taste good and they are good for you. So those are go foods. But whoa foods taste good. They're kind of not that great for your body. And if you eat them, you need to remember to brush your teeth. So pie and gobs of ice cream and cookies, not that great for you. And gum. But let's see what happened to the tooth fairy's broken wand. Uh-oh. So when the tooth fairy's wand is broken, topsy-turvy tooth fairy trouble. Oh, no. Everything is swirling all out of control. It seems to be a storm. And look, Kaylee and the tooth fairy are both under the table crying. Oh, no. Kaylee and the tooth fairy may have been soaked and scared and stunned, but luckily, Kaylee had one more trick up her pajama sleeve. Quick, hand me the sprayer. This bubble gum fixed my wand. Oh, so she gets the bubble gum and she takes some of that gobs of gum. And she wraps it around and she fixes the tooth fairy's wand. And then the Tooth Fairy has another trick. She uses her wand and they help clean up the mess together. And it says, bye-bye, little fur balls. So with her magic wand, she sends the cats and dogs away and they clean up all the mess they made from the globs of ice cream and the globs of gum and from that spicy pie. Now, if you know anything about pranksters and fairies, you know there's room for lots of fairy dust cookies and another woe food, right? Cookies. This book is full of them. It's okay to have a treat every once in a while, but you want to make sure you brush your teeth and protect your smile. And look at Kaylee's smile. You see where her tooth is missing from? So they had a party and look, she actually gives the Tooth Fairy the tooth. Did you notice? Her little tooth box is empty and it's in her hand. Two prank princesses and one new friendship. And then coming down the street, this kid is saying, I think my tooth is loose. And who's waiting up here? The prank princesses with water balloons. And they've used the Tooth Fairy sack to tie the water balloons in. Was that a fun story or what? The end. So we learned about woe foods. And remember, I was telling you that if you eat woe foods like cookies and ice cream and cake and pie, you gotta eat them once in a while and you gotta brush your teeth to protect your smile. So let's look at our friend over here. It looks like he's had some woe foods and they are all over his teeth. And we don't want him to have dog breath, so we are gonna help him brush his teeth. So I'm gonna pretend, and this shaving cream is gonna be our pretend toothpaste, but this is real toothpaste, okay? So we are gonna put some pretend toothpaste on a real toothbrush for some fun, okay? There we go. Full toothbrush. All right, and we have a song for this activity, so let's get ready for this. Ready? Wrong song. Here we go. That's our
when you wake up in the morning, it's 12:45, and you want to have a little fun. You brush your teeth. You brush your teeth. When you wake up in the morning, it's 12:45, and you want to find something to do. You brush your teeth. You brush your teeth. And when you wake up in the morning, it's 2:45, and your mind starts humming, twiddly-dee. You brush your teeth. You brush your teeth. When you wake up in the morning, it's 3:45, and you think you hear a knock on your door. You brush your teeth. You brush your teeth. When you wake up in the morning, it's 4:45, and you just can't wait to come alive. You brush your teeth. You brush your teeth. You brush your teeth. You brush your teeth.
So we brush all of the gunk and all of the woe foods off of our friend's smile to protect him from having dog breath, right? And we're just saying that dog breath is bad breath. But you know what happens if you don't protect your baby teeth when they finally come out and you get your adult teeth in, you have a second chance to do a better job. But guess what happens if you don't do a better job protecting your teeth? And how do you protect your teeth? When you eat woe foods, you eat them once in a while, you brush your teeth to protect your smile. You brush your teeth twice a day and you floss all the gunk and crumbs away, okay? And what's a great practice is when you brush your teeth, if you use a timer like this one, You flip it over. This is called like a sand timer. You flip it over and you see the sand is falling down. Let's see if we can get a better picture of it. It's going down even if you can't see it. And then once it goes all the way down, you flip it over again and you keep brushing. And then after it all goes down, you're done. Just like when we wash our hands, we say front and back and in between, wash your hands till they are clean. Scrub and rub those germs away and you will have a healthy day. We sing that song so that we can wash our hands for 20 seconds. So if you're doing a good job brushing your teeth, you get yourself a little timer, and they give these away sometimes when you go to the dentist, and you let the sand go down one side and then you flip it and let it go down the other side. But guess what? My friend right here, unfortunately, we're gonna have to see what his checkout is. His chart says, let me see what his chart says about his medical health, his dental health. Uh-oh. It says that this guy eats lots of woe foods, is not so good at brushing his teeth or flossing. Let's see what kind of teeth he's gonna have after Miss Nicole, dentist Miss Nicole, does his checkup. Alrighty, let's see. Let me get in here. Excuse me while I give this man a checkup. We'll be right back. Let me see what else we're gonna do over here. Got some tweezers. I'm gonna pick up some food. Don't look yet. Don't look yet. Just turn them around so you can't really see everything that's going on. Oh no, there's lots of work needs to be done in here. Let's see what we need from. We need the little drill that they clean your teeth out with. Okay. I could give him braces, but you know what? I don't think he'll need braces. I'll tell you a story. Miss Nicole used to wear braces. I sure did. I had to wear braces for a number of years because my teeth were not straight. So I got braces so that it could straighten them out. And I'm just going to give him a complimentary brush. And let's see. Unfortunately, sir, I couldn't do much to save your smile. You didn't do a great job of eating go foods, and when you ate woe foods once in a while, you did not protect your smile. Uh-oh, he's falling to pieces because guess what? He's toothless now. He didn't protect his teeth, and he doesn't even really have a smile. This is my Play-Doh friend, and actually we can make him teeth to go inside, but I just thought it would be a fun demonstration of how you have to protect your teeth. So say it with me. When you eat woe foods once in a while, brush your teeth to protect your smile. Let's say that again. I'm gonna put all of my, look, I even had a drill to take care of his teeth. Are you ready? So that you can remember. And I'll even show you some coloring sheets that are fun. So I like these coloring sheets because it's showing two people brushing their teeth. So what do we say? When you eat woe foods once in a while, brush your teeth and protect your smile. Thank you for joining me. Thank you for joining me. See you next time. And remember, you are the you in unique.